recorded along Florida's Big Bend region, southeast of the state capital of Tallahassee.
This is probably the worst I've seen since Floyd. This is why they asked for people to evacuate.
I'm Jason Douglas. I'm one of the three co-founders of Dragoon Technology. Dragoon was founded with the idea that we wanted to build aircraft that could fly longer distances, longer durations, at lower cost. But NOAA is the National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Administration. They do a lot of weather-related research. This project is about hurricanes. They're funding an aircraft that its intent is to fly out from land across the ocean up to 1,000 miles away into a storm and take data they can't currently get or that's too expensive to get. And one of the pieces of data they need is three-dimensional winds, so both lateral winds but also vertical up and down, and that gives them a lot of information about the sea-air interface and what the energy transfers are. The end goal of gathering this data that the wind probe will assist in gathering is to make forecasts for hurricanes more accurate and more timely. So you may choose to evacuate or not evacuate an entire city based on where you think the storm is going. This information will make that guess better. Commercial probes that are available right now are very expensive, so up to $7,000 or more. And in order to hit the cost targets of the Coriolis aircraft and do the mission that we want it to do, which includes being disposable, cost price, cost levels, we need to get that price way, way, way down. And so that $100 target at volume is critical.
Hi, I'm Glenn Sears, and I'm the software engineering lead.
Hi, I'm Trevor Bailey. I'm the electrical lead for the project.
Hi, I'm John Franklin. I'm the systems and mechanical lead for the project.
Hi, I'm Ashley Holt, and I'm the aerodynamics lead for our project.
Hi. My name is Carlton Louie. I'm the project lead, and this is the Coriolis Wind Probe.
The Coriolis Wind Probe is a five-hole probe, which uses the pressure difference across five different holes to measure the pitch, yaw, and relative wind speed. The functional requirements for the project was that it had to be durable and be able to withstand hurricane conditions, be minimally invasive onto the host aircraft, the Coriolis, and lastly, be cost-effective to produce. Over this past year, we've created a design that addresses all of these requirements, featuring an SLA-printed probe, a custom PCB, and our custom software package, Zephyrus.
So the Coriolis wind probe is broken up into four main assemblies. We have the electrical, the structural, the mounting, and the computer assembly, and all these have to work together so that the probe can accurately sense winds and transmit that data to the host aircraft. So the way the Coriolis wind probe works is wind blows across the structural assembly probe head. That data is transferred into the electronic system through differential pressure sensors where our microcontroller calculates those data vectors. Then all the power and data gets transferred through a Mullex connector to be able to interface with the host aircraft. Everything is held in place on our system by the mounting assembly, which is 3D printed parts that are glued in place inside of the wing, which makes sure everything is secure during flight. The electrical assembly is really where the heart and the brains meet of the project. It basically serves four major functions. You have the differential pressure sensors, which are doing the actual data collection from the probe. Then we have the microcontroller, which is doing all of our calculations and computing those vectors. We have a power supply, which is able to convert the bus voltage that's 40 to 60 volts of the actual aircraft down to the 3.3 that we operate at. And then we have a Mullex connector, and we're running communications and power from the host aircraft to our system through it. Coming into the project, we had two options. We could have either gone with six single port pressure sensors or three differential pressure sensors. So we ended up going for the less traditional three differential pressure sensor route, since that would allow us to cut down on the cost and also the footprint of our board. PCB's been a long time coming. That's kind of the culmination of the entire year's worth of work. Everything started out on a breadboard with just the sensors plugged in and a pre-made microcontroller allowing me to communicate and make sure everything worked. And then moving up into testing, there was a Rev 1 board, which was just a step up to solder everything down instead of it being on a breadboard. And then once we tested that and found out that design worked, there was a board for prototyping to make sure we could program the microcontroller. And then the final board is just a culmination of all of those steps and putting it onto one single board.
The software on the Coriolis wind probe connects all the different subcomponents of the electrical system together, allowing them to communicate. So this allows us to get the data from a sensor, compute it, and send it down to the host aircraft. Mavlink is the communication protocol
that is used on the host aircraft's autopilot. Mavlink allows us to then use an external board, like we are in our electronics assembly, to talk back to that main board and communicate any data that we may be collecting.
The mechanical assembly of the probe fits into two main categories. The first is the probe itself, and the second is the mounting assembly. The probe itself consists of 5 holes at the front and a little bit down the shaft, a 6th hole. The 5 holes are the 4 differential pressure ports and the 1 airspeed port. The 6th hole is the static port, which is used in conjunction with the airspeed port. The mounting assembly consists of 5 key components. The probe guide, front fascia plate, the hatch, the dovetail mounts. Throughout this project, the mechanical assembly underwent several major design changes and iterations. Initially, the mechanical assembly involved a large section of the wing being removed all at one time and was a clamshell design. So the entire assembly would be put together and then inserted into the wing all at once. Then finally, we arrived at our current assembly in order to address these concerns. Our current assembly only has 2 screws which go into carbon fiber and are not under load, holding the hatch door in place. All the other components are bonded into the wing, and the concerns about ease of assembly have been addressed with the dovetail mounts and the electronics assembly, and a reduction in fasteners from over 12 fasteners down to 4 total fasteners to put the assemblies together. In addition to updating the mounting aspects of the mechanical assembly, we also had several iterations on the probe itself. Initially, the probe consisted of 4 components, in fact, 2 shaft components, 1 static pressure accumulator, and the probe tip. The shafts initially were made out of carbon fiber, which was a concern for our sponsor because carbon fiber is expensive, and they had concerns over manufacturing and difficulty in assembling and bonding that carbon fiber to our 3D printed components. So what we were able to do was take this entire 4 component assembly and simplify it down to 1 single component. This single component has internal ports inside of it to convey the pressures from the tip of the probe and the integrated static pressure port down to the end of the probe, where barbed fittings allow hoses to be connected to move this pressure to the differential pressure sensors in the electronics assembly.
For the initial design, we focused on a lot of research papers in order to get down basic geometries for the tip, as well as our 3 sensor setup. We ended up using the wind tunnel for a lot of our tests because it provides a controlled setting. Essentially, we can control the speed as well as the angles that we put the probe at, instead of just putting it out into the environment not knowing what the air velocity is going to be. So we're using STAR-CCM for our CFD program. Essentially, what we're doing is we're putting in just the plane aircraft and then analyzing it and then adding our probe to it, analyzing that. And we found that it had a minimal effect on our drag.
So there you have it. We create a design that is compact and elegant, cost-effective, and lastly, accurate. Our team is excited to see how the data that this probe will gather will affect people's lives. Thank you.